Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss the Sangam Age. Now, first of all, there is a question: what is Sangam Age and what is the time period of the Sangam Age and why we call it Sangam Age? The Sangam Age, the time period of Sangam Age is from 3 BC to 3 AD based on the various sources like literary sources, archaeological sources and the coins which is available, which we find in the excavation. So we know about the time period is 3 BC to 3 AD. Now what is Sangam? Sangam is means assembly of the poet. This assembly of the poet is happened under the patronage of the Pandya's king, and that's why this is called as the Sangam Age based on the literary and the archaeological sources. In the Sangam Age there were the three kingdoms. First is Chola, second is Chera and third is Pandya. Let's first of all we check the map. So this is Chola. In the eastern part there is Chola and the Pandya. In the western part there is Chera. Right, now we discuss first of all their capital. What are their capital? Chola's capital was at Uriavur, which was later shifted to Puhar. Puhar is also known as the Kaveri Patnam, which is also the port and the Kaveri River. Now we come to Chera. Chera capital was Vanji and Pandya's capital was Madurai. Now we come to the emblem. What were their emblem? If we see in the map, you see that the Chola is represented by tiger. So their emblem was tiger. Pandya's was represented by fish, or you can say carp, and Chera was represented by bow. Now if we want to remember Pandya, you know a Pandav. There is a story of Mahabharata in which there was Pandav, and in these Pandavs there was one Pandav which is known as Arjun, who hit a eye of a revolving fish. So with this story, with this Arjun and with this fish, you can remember that Pandya's emblem was fish. So this is the chronology which you can drive between the two, Pandya's and Madurai and fish. And that's why I have written here Arjun. You can correlate it with the story of Arjuna, which is given under Mahabharata. Now we come to who were the most famous rulers of Cholas. The Cholas most famous ruler during the Sangam Age was the Kraikal, and Chera's Shengutuan and Nedu Jilian. The most important thing about Shengutuan that he has started a cult known as the Patni cult, or the worship of the Kanagi. Kanagi means wife. So he has started a cult in which there was the worship of the wife, like there is Karwa Chauth in which there is a worship of a husband. In similar way, he has started a cult known as the Patni cult. Pandya's were most important for pearls, while the Cholas most important for cotton. C for Cholas and C for cotton. Now port I have already defined that is Puhar, which is also known as the Kaveri Patnam, was the most important port of the Cholas. Other than that, there was other port like Arikamedu, which is known as today as Pondicherry. Pondicherry time during the Sangam Age was Arikamedu. Chera's port were Tondi and Museri, and the Pandya's port was Korkai. Now we come to the Sangam literature. Sangam literature, I have already defined that Sangam is nothing but the assembly of the Tamil poet, which was happened under the patronage of the Pandya's king. It is also known as Machachangam. Sangam is also known as Machachangam. So this question can be asked in UPSC directly, that is what was Machachangam, because it is the alternative name of the Sangam that you should study it. Now there was three Sangam: first Sangam, second Sangam and the third Sangam. First Sangam was organized as Madurai, but no literary evidence was left out, right? And the chairman was known as the father of Tamil literature, and that was Agastya Mahamuni. He has done the chairmanship of the two Sangam, first and second. And second Sangam was happened at Kapadpuram. The most important thing about second Sangam that we get a book, and the name of that book was Tolkapiyam, which was written by Tolkapiyar. What is special about this book? First, this is a Tamil grammar book, first Tamil grammar book. Second, it gives us an idea about society, polity, culture and economy of Sangam Age. Now third Sangam was held at Madurai. the most important literature which was of a third Sangam was Itutongai, Patupatu, Pathlin Kilnaku, and two epics, Shilpadigrama and Manimekhalai. Shilpadigrama and Manimekhalai. These two epics, Shilpadigrama. Shilpadigrama is written by Ilongge Adigil, who was the younger brother of the Chera king, Cher Shenguttuvan. And Manimekhalai was written by Sitlai Satnar. The most important was Pathlin Kilnaku, that this is nothing but a set of 18 books, which is written on ethics and morals. And the most important book was Thirukkural, which was written by Thiruvallavar. Now we see the image of that saint, Thiruvallavar. The Thirukkural, which is a book of ethical, which is a book written on ethics and moral, is written by saint Thiruvallavar. The name of the saint was Thiruvallavar. So this is the most important from where question can be asked. So this is our first part. Second part, link is given in the description. Please watch the second part, which is based on the 11th class Tamil Nadu NCERT, which will give you everything for the UPSC exam. You don't need to study anything other than this chapter on the Sangam Age for the UPSC prelims as well as for mains. And there is a request to you, if you like it, please share it on Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, wherever you can share it. Please share it. I will be thankful to you. Thank you.